I like to focus on these small crustaceans that are in all of our lakes. And when I found out that this bloody red shrimp entered the Great Lakes, I thought, wow, this is really interesting. And because it is also included among the zooplankton, I thought, I gotta get in on the ground floor here. I wanna find out what it's doing. The mesocosms are really useful because they allow us to somewhat mimic the real ecosystem out there in Lake Michigan. We can mimic water movement because we have an inflow right away from the lake. So over the years I've conducted with graduate students and undergraduates many experiments on this critter. For students, it's a unique opportunity to be involved in this research, and they can come in here and be a part of taking samples or even setting up the experiment. In our experiments here on Beaver Island, we want to see on a larger scale in these mesocosms if these bloody red shrimp can actually have an effect on the whole zooplankton community and the whole phytoplankton community. And so our idea is that if the bloody red shrimp are eating all the zooplankton, there won't be food left for the young fish.